Lady Theodess. I can't do that. Hello again. I've received word that Lord Gathbin is amassing an army of mercenaries near Yenwood Field. It appears a peaceful claim to Caed Nua is no longer possible. Yenwood Field. The Earl has sent me to aid you in forming your own force to counter this threat. I'm here in an advisory role only, of course. The Earl won't officially take sides in this dispute. Why won't the Earl officially legitimize my claim? It is a delicate situation. Legally, Lord Gathbin's claim is just, and he knows it. Stripping land and title from a noble family is quite dangerous, maybe more so than killing the man outright. With Gathbin dead, the Earl only need worry about blood vengeance from family members that actually cared for Lord Gathbin. Those, if court gossip is to be believed, are few and far between. Losing a family claim to land and title, though? Such disputes incite hatred from the entire clan and their political allies, not to mention the unease it caused amongst the other nobles. Wars are started for less. No. If Lord Gathbin is to be denied, it will be you who must prove your legitimacy to the Earl and all others who would dispute your claims. This is what it means to be noble in the Deerwood. If there's anything else you wish to know, please ask. I have a fortress with strong walls. Why not let Gathbin's army come to me? Lord Gathbin isn't fool enough to risk tearing down Caed Nua just to kill you. If you shield yourself behind these walls, he'll have free rein to torment your subjects in the countryside. Earl Badmore, I will see your inactions against Lord Gathbin as a sign that you're unwilling to perform your duties as Lord of Caed Nua. Losing his support will have dire consequences. Taking the fight to Lord Gathbin is your only option. How much time do I have? Enough. It's rumored Lord Gathbin will suffer a series of unfortunate and completely unforeseeable setbacks before his army is complete. He grins and winks. Still, I'd not tarry long. I wonder what he's set up here. Let's talk about my army. The marshal nods. Where am I getting my troops? I've sent out a call for volunteers from the lands around Caed Nua. Hopefully people will realize that being under your rule is preferable to that of Lord Gathbin's. Any hireling stationed at Caed Nua will also accompany you to the battle, so I suggest you acquire as many of those as possible. Okay, I'll hire more. I received a missive from the Knights of the Crucible. They've heard about the situation and will send a squad of their finest knights when the time for battle comes. Cool, so that figures into the whole thing that we helped the Crucible Knights. Believe it or not, but your friends in the Flames That Whisper clan have heard about your trouble with Lord Gathbin. Matron Berrigan said something about a vision. In any case, a messenger from Stalwart said that Berrigan is sending some of her clan to your aid. Cool. Ogres. You've made some Red Saren friends, I see. I've been told to expect a unit of Pathfinders, courtesy of Adaric. Excellent. The Iron Flail. What's the status of my regular troops? The Marshal shakes his head. Too green and too few. If you go up against Lord Gathbin now, losses will be heavy. However, victory is still possible. We need to recruit veteran troops. I know a company or two of veterans that would be willing to join us for a bit of coin. I'd say 10,000 copper should cover the expenses. Do it. His eyes widen. It will be done. What special allies do I have available? The Knights of the Crucible will reinforce your infantry. Several Crag Ogres from the Flames That Whisper clan will join with your infantry. Elite Red Saren Pathfinders will join your archers. That's all for now. So, Lord Gathbin hasn't given up on taking Caed Nua from me. He's tried to have me killed, stirred up trouble in the land around Caed Nua, and now he's raising an army against me. Lord Gathbin is assembling an army of mercenaries in an attempt to wrest control from Caed Nua from me by force. I'll need to raise my own army to stop him. Marshal Forwyn will assist me in the logistics of it all, coordinating things at the Great Hall in Caed Nua. He'll wait here until I command my army to march to Yenwood Field. My allies and the Knights of the Crucible will send some of their veteran knights to aid my infantry, assuming I remain in their good favor until the battle. I'm not going to be doing anything. Matron Berrigan has promised to send some of her ogres on my way to aid my infantry. Adaric will be sending a contingent of longbowmen to aid my archers in the battle against Lord Gathpin. Okay. So... let's hire some of these other guys. I guess these guys with the letters are hired on. We got a cleric, a blooded thug. These are all 10 copper. Can't add any more hirelings. Hopefully all this stuff is still good. Yes. Okay, my regular troops, I guess, were the hirelings. It's as good as it can be, given the circumstances. With your willingness to spend coin, we should attract some veteran warriors as well. They'll be useful for your experience and will help with morale if the situation becomes dire. It's time, Marshal. Assemble the army and march to Yenwood Field. Excellent. Morale is high, and the troops are eager to follow you to glory. Are you certain you wish to march? Yes, I'm sure. Give the order. As you command, I'll march the army to Yenwood Field. Will you be accompanying us? We're getting, like, mad experience, but unfortunately we are at max level. Yes, let's march. Cool. As you crest a small hill overlooking Yenwood Field, Lord Gathpin's army is a flurry of activity, scurrying to and fro. Even from this distance, you can hear the drums of war, beating their steady cadence designed to intimidate their foes, while organizing the rank and file into battle formations. Marshal Forwyn approaches. You've arrived just in time. Lord Gathpin's forces are beginning to move. An attack is imminent. Any idea what Gathpin is planning? He strokes his chin. His ultimate objective is to face you in battle and to be seen defeating you. I doubt he is foolish enough to challenge you to single combat, of course. Oh crap, we forgot to rest. Hope that won't make a difference. Inspect your forces. Local militia constitutes the majority of the army, but veteran soldiers have organized the ranks and walk amongst the young. The young unseasoned warriors offering advice or the occasional joke. They cheer, striking sword to shield as you pass, in thunderous approval of their lord. Among the troops, a small group of warriors shine brighter than the others, crucible knights standing tall in gleaming plate armor and armed with spear and shield. They stand at attention, spear-centered, as you pass. You pass a group of crag ogres working themselves into a frenzy. They carve jagged wounds across each other's chests and back, and their war cries echoing throughout the camp. Your troops give them a wide berth. A squad of Red Saren Pathfinders make ready for the upcoming battle. War bows are strung and quivers are filled as you pass. One of the archers spots you and whistles. Silently, each of them places a closed fist over heart in salute. Yeah, I kind of wish we could go back and rest, but it's too late for that now. Sound the horn, Marshal Forwyn. It's time to finish this. Marshal Forwyn begins barking orders, and your troops quickly form up. Gathpin's army follows suit as a Darren war drums echo across the field. Within a few moments, the marshal raises a brass horn in the visage of a mighty boar to his lips. He looks at you expectantly.
Oh.
Oh my god! I don't know. Most of these troops don't have any attachment to Caed Nua. For Caed Nua. Your troops bellow across the field, pounding weapon to shield as the marshal's horn sounds. Dozens of bowstrings twang in unison behind you as your archers unleash a hail of arrows at Gaspin's army. The missiles hiss through the air with deadly accuracy, felling scores of enemies. In a bold move, Gaspin points his sword towards your position, giving an unheard order. His infantry, shields raised, charge the field. Your infantry charges headlong into the enemy infantry in the center of the field. The cacophonous sound of metal on metal is nearly deafening as the two forces collide. The fighting is fierce and the screams of the dying numerous. Led by veteran warriors rallied to your cause, the troops fight valiantly and appear to be holding their ground. The battle thus far appears to be a stalemate. Oh no. Then, a group of Adirian battle mages emerges from behind the enemy lines. They begin weaving their hands in unison with practiced precision. Suddenly, waves of arcane fire erupt among your troops. The acrid smell of smoke and burning flesh is nearly overwhelming. Any of my guys have spells? From the left flank, a unit of Ra'atai berserkers, clad in plate armor and wielding greatswords, begins to collapse on the left side of the line. The ground is thick with the dead as they press their advantage. Oh my. Meanwhile, bleak walker paladins dressed in dark armor and carrying sword and shield stride back and forth behind Gathbin's lines, rallying his warriors and exhorting them to fight harder. As the battle rages, Marshal Forwin looks to you for orders. We settle the battlefield? Your troops fight bravely and your lines are holding for the moment. Gethman's army is slowly pushing you back and casualties are mounting. Defeat is likely. We need to deal with those battle mages. What's your plan, Lord Theodas? Order the Red Saren Pathfinders to give him a few volleys. Accurate arrow fire from the Red Sarens disrupts and fells many of the battle mages, but arcane defenses thwart some of the arrows. The survivors retreat from the battle and move out of range, but not before hurling a volley of fireballs into your archers' ranks. The screams of the dying echo in your ears as the Red Sarens are set afire. I figure ranged attacks were the best way to reach them, since they weren't really on the battlefield, right? Take out the berserkers. What unit should I send? Forwin bellows over the din of battle. Sound the charge for our ogre allies. I love it. The crag ogres fearlessly charge the berserker enemies. The fighting is brutal as both Ra'atai and ogre warriors refuse to give ground. But the size and strength of the ogre shock troops proves too much for the smaller Ra'atai. When the smoke clears, not a single berserker is left standing. The bleak walkers must die. Marshal Forwin avoids an incoming arrow before answering, "And how do you plan on doing that?" "Send in the Crucible Knights." At the sound of Marshal Forwin's horn, the leader of Crucible Knights, a justiciar with a long graying beard, issues a challenge to the Bleakwalker captain. The steel-clad formations clash and battle furiously. Both heavily armored units fare well against the other, but the Crucible Knights appear to have the upper hand. The heavy losses inflicted on Gathbin's troops have clearly lifted morale. Your troops push forward with renewed vigor while Gathbin's army is slowly losing ground. Excuse me, victory is within your grasp. Everyone on me! Charge! As the remainder of your forces charge, a horn sounds in the distance. A new contingent of warriors crest the nearby hill. As Gathbin's reinforcements trudge headlong into the fray, his other troops cheer triumphantly. The hell's this? Shouts of joy turn to roars of dismay as the new arrivals begin attacking Gathbin's infantry. You make out the figure of Captain Emery, leading the charge in her dark armor. She kills one of Gathbin's men with a well-armed pistol shot before running another through with a gleaming rapier. She fells one foe after another, pausing briefly at one point to salute you with her sword from across the battlefield. Now, if we had fought them and killed them, we wouldn't have this help. And of course you realize that she's playing it safe. She waits until she says, well, yeah, it looks like they're going to defeat them. Let's help. So it's actually a good thing. We probably could have won without them, but we're actually losing more of our men this way. Less of our men. We're losing less of our men, is what I meant. The betrayal by their reinforcements breaks the will of Gathbin's regulars. They drop sword and shield and flee the battlefield in a full rout. Theodas! Lord Gathbin strides through the carnage, his elite guard accompanying him. The day can still be mine if I take your head. Come now. It's time I put you down like the dog you are. Salute Gathbin with your weapon. We have to run up and get these guys. Attack!
No problem.
Cool. This is awesome. Well, it's too bad we can't actually help our... We can't help them, can we? Oh, we are! We're targeting all of them with Holy Radiance. Cool. I like that. We're not really controlling them, but our spells can affect them. Which probably means we need to be careful as well. Like, if I use this... Oh, it doesn't hit them. It doesn't look like it does. Anyway, I'm just gonna have him take a wizard's double. Just a 41 here. I have to get him some more of these. I might have some more. Doesn't Canna have knocked down too? Maybe not because he has that. Oh my god. I'm gonna target as many people as I can. While realizing some people are gonna move. Looks like we could talk to that guy. We can't talk to him. It's just the speech icon comes up though. I don't even know where we are right now. What's Lord Gaspin? I want to deal with him personally. Got three. We can summon a few drakes if we wait. If we wait for four. Oh, you know what? Mwahahaha. Boom. Oh, we can do it. Bring on the drakes. Pure chaos. Can I I can direct them as well? I didn't know that. What Gathpin's almost done for. This guy's almost dead. Oh, that's her. Anybody hanging around not doing anything? You know, I'm not sure I'm controlling them. I think I'm just controlling the special forces. Gaspin's dead. Heck, I'm not controlling. Nice. Lord Gathman lies dead before you, his army scattered. Bloodied and exhausted, your remaining troops look to you, swords raised high in victory, chanting your name. Theodas! 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 That's awesome. Holding the hem of his robe as he steps over several bodies, Chancellor Warren approaches you. Although his face is pale, and he looks as if he will be sick at any moment, he forces a smile. Lady Theodas, while I am grateful this dispute is finally over, it is regrettable so many lives were lost in the process. Gathbin should have been just been reasonable from the start. He gags involuntarily as his silk boot brushes against his severed head. In any event, as the legal arbiter of Earl Badmore, I'm here to inform you that you've been declared a Thanu of the Deerwood, and Caed Nua has been recognized as your domain. It shall forever be thus, and will pass down to any descendants you may have in the future. Of course, now that your claim has been upheld, you're expected to forward a small portion of any taxes you collect to your rightful lord, Earl Badmore. Well, I really want to choose four, but I feel that would be foolish. I'm just gonna nod. Well then, if everything is in order, the Chancellor clears his throat. It appears my work is done. Feel free to visit the palace if... He steps in a pile of entrails with a wet squish as he turns to leave. On second thought, I'll come and visit you. Yes, yes. Perhaps in a year or three. Marshal Forwin says, Lady Theodas, it's been an honor to serve you. I'll be making my way back to Garen's grasp. The Earl has some urgent business for me there, unfortunately. Should you ever find yourself that far north, feel free to call on me. I'd love to trade war stories with you over a cup or two. He grasps your hand briefly in a firm grip, then turns on his heel. And taxes were already collected. Oh, we got all the spoils, the Sylvan Sturge added. Since the end of the Saints' War, dear Woodens have gathered at Evondure Bridge to commemorate the sacrifice of the dozen who gave their lives to defeat St. Widwin. It has become customary for priests of Magrin leading the processional to sing a dirge to end the ceremony. This year, when the priest attempted to sing the dirge, his tongue swelled in his throat, and he died painfully before the assembled crowd. When another priest attempted to sing the dirge a month later, he suffered the same fate. Some believe the gods are to blame for the priest's deaths. Others suspect vengeful Red Sarins. Whoever is to blame, the priesthood of Magrin and the soldiers of Godhammer Citadel want them brought to justice. Assign... Maneha. Give her something to do. I got all this stuff. Still collecting all the fine and exceptional stuff. Cloak of Protection. Ooh. Oh, this comes from Gathbin himself. We've had one of those. Blunting Belt. Ring of Unshackling. Have those. Is that Adra? What's that? That's pretty random. Plus 5 damage reduction, pierce and slash. This belt is comprised of several layers of leather wound around small round pieces of metal. The resulting effect is not unlike brigandine, though the belt's sturdiness only reflects those arcane protections woven into the material, for the belt grants uncommon resistance against cutting and piercing weapons. That's not that great. Only plus 5. Gathbin family signet grants lord's authority One per stronghold turn. Plus 10% ability area of effect. This ring has been passed down from father to son in the Gathbin family for generations. Thanks to you, that tradition has been permanently shattered. Though made for Gathbin, the power of the ring is commanded to the rule of Caed Nua itself. Lord's authority. Plus 5 might, plus 5 resolve. Immunity to charm, dominated for 30 seconds. Per stronghold turn. I'll keep it on me. Token of my victory. More goodies. Do we sell this stuff? I'm sure. Yeah.
Got it.
Interesting. Battlefield. Where are we? We're not on the map. I don't think there's anything else for us to find. I just keep looking, though. Oh, hey, we almost missed out on 3 copper, whatever the hell that was. Back to Caed Nua, then.
Gelade, well done.
Oh, God.
A formidable fortress.
Sheepy time. Okay, guys. 2 dragons to kill. And some guy called Theos to kill. Maybe you've heard of him. And then we're done with the game. I can't believe it. We're done. Hopefully I can kill them. Pretty sure we can kill Theos. We kind of... if I remember right, we had him like half dead. And I don't know what we were. Level 12? Maybe? We're 16 now? Plus we have... now we have an...
Eh?
I forgot to mention... I didn't realize. C- Council Hall. Well, you have to look at him in battle. He has 210 endurance, which is pretty good. Which is kind of like what I think. Aloth's endurance. Yeah, not that great at all, but he has 1,260 health. He has 994. Oh, that's not the... Okay. Never mind. It's still good for a summoned thing. So, he is going to be very useful in the battles to come. So, thanks so much for watching. See you next time for some dragon battles. Hopefully I win at least one of them. And yeah, see you then. Endure and enduring, grow strong.